What's up, guys? It is Jay Beeps here, and welcome to this first episode of a brand new series. So, if you are familiar with my channel, you've probably seen I've done similar experience with this on Madden. So, basically, I'm going to be drafting 53 offensive linemen, and then I will have to make those 53 linemen into a full 53-man roster. I've done this with quarterbacks, and I've done this with running backs. Now, I'm just excited making my way through. I decided I really want to do it with the offensive linemen. So, that being said, let's go ahead and let's start our fantasy draft.
The
Now,
Cardinals
first
are now
pick,
on the
it's going to be a little
clock.
bit controversial, but after I explain to you why, it'll all make sense. So, my first pick is Lane Johnson. And you may be thinking, why in the world am I taking Lane Johnson right away? Well, that's because as far
The
as
Cardinals are now on the
offensive linemen
clock.
go, he is the best quarterback as an offensive lineman. That's therefore. Obviously, this team is not going to have a quarterback. So, I'm going to have to go through and make sure that, we actually get someone who can actually, throw the ball more than 5 yards.
The Cardinals are now on the clock.
And obviously, just really going to go through, pick players based on development trait.
The Cardinals are
Just
now on
because
the
it's
clock.
that's going to be so key is to get this team to progress quickly. Like in my quarterback, all quarterback fantasy draft, best thing I ever did was have those players with the higher development trait because we just need those players to develop pretty much
The
as quickly as
Cardinals are now on
possible.
the clock.
Because if we are able to do so, then the team can get better. Then just once we start playing better, we can do more things, and then just the entire team starts to
The
get
Cardinals are
better
now on the
altogether.
clock.
So that's why I'm doing that. So obviously this team,
The
offensively, we're probably
Cardinals
going to
are now
be
on the clock.
a very power-heavy running team, which is why I've decided to use the Vikings offensive playbook. Just because, again,
The
this team is
Cardinals
obviously
are now
full of
on
a
the
bunch of
clock.
300-pound plus men. So we are going to look to pound the rock a lot. Defensively, looking to go for a we're going to go for a 4-3 look just because just want as
The
many
Cardinals are now on
players
the
in the
clock.
box as possible because I think we might have we'll probably have a pretty decent run defense. It's just the issue is going to be that pass defense. And another plus with this is since I obviously am taking all these linemen
The Cardinals are
is
now
that
on
I'm
the clock.
taking these linemen away from other teams. So obviously with every with all these experiments of this type, obviously there is going to be those advantages. Like in my all quarterback fantasy draft, I was facing 60 overall quarterbacks in the regular season as starters because I took so many quarterbacks. So, I mean,
The
realistically, teams
Cardinals are
won't be
now on
having
the
that
clock.
good of offensive lines. Definitely won't in the preseason. So it'll really just be interesting to see how it all folds out.
The Cardinals are now on the clock.
So at least the nice thing is, since there is like five different positions I'm technically picking from. There are a lot of a very wide variety of players and a lot of players
The
that have good
Cardinals are now on the clock.
I guess you'd say good development traits. 'Cause I mean
The Cardinals
what
are
was
now
that? That
on the
was the
clock.
13th round and we just picked up another superstar. So it's just the little things like that don't really seem like much but are going to significantly help the team. So obviously, giant weakness is
The Cardinals are now on the
team's
clock.
lack of speed and catching. And that is going to be something we're going to have to find a way to work around.
The Cardinals are now on the clock.
I don't really know how things are actually going to end up working out. But I do know this is going to be quite the interesting experiment, to say the least.
The Cardinals are
Another
now
really
on the
nice thing
clock.
about this is overalls don't matter at all, because I mean, pretty much all these players are going to end up
The Cardinals are now on
as
the
like
clock.
some of these players could be lining up at corner, so it doesn't matter how good of a blocker they are. It's just again, first development trait, and then we can hit the physicals as far as like speed, strength, all of that stuff. Right, so I think we're now at the
The
point where
Cardinals are now on the clock.
it's just normal players. But we'll still see though. Development trait. Alright, so yeah, left tackles are at normal. I think Peters is
The
a star.
Cardinals are now on the clock.
So I think now we're at the point, I think all the stars might be taken. Oh no, we still got a couple of star centers.
The Cardinals are now on the clock.
I'm really excited for this thing, for this series to play out.
The Cardinals are now
Just
on the clock.
Obviously, with these experiments, literally anything can happen, and you don't really ever know what is actually going to end up happening. Which is why I'm so excited. Alright, so development traits pretty much are gone, so now we're gonna go for speed. We'll take a couple of quicker centers. Another thing is we do have to kind of like move through the whole entire offensive line selections. Like we haven't taken an actual left tackle yet. All right, let's get some let's look for strength. We'll get three. We'll get four strong left tackles. And then we'll probably hit up. I don't know, actually.
The Cardinals are now on the clock.
I think now we're just at the point where we'll just go through and we'll take five. We'll take a player from each offensive line position. And just really see how it ends up working. Alright, yeah. Nate Solder.
The Cardinals are now on the clock.
Because the biggest issue I've had with these experiments is getting the team to gel right away and figuring out what's going to work. Because, I mean, obviously, this isn't a regular NFL team. You can't just, oh, well, let's put this
clock.
type of game plan together. It's, oh, no, we have no ability to pass the ball, but we can run the ball. But we can only run the ball if they line up in this type of defense. But if they don't line up in that type of defense, then what are we supposed to do? Gotta take the legend, Will Clapp. Alright, so now we're just gonna, we'll see what filters there are for the right tackle. We'll go for acceleration. At least the nice thing is with this is we don't really have to worry about, do I want to go for more of a 3-4, you know, what kind of look do I want to go for? It's just, yeah, I'll take a couple of faster players.
The Cardinals are now on the clock.
You know, at this point, we're not drafting because of skill or to fit the scheme. We're just drafting because of physical ability.
The Cardinals are now on the clock.
Okay, so one thing I totally forgot to do was kicker and punter, because there are players that I do want to take a kicker and punter, but I'm pretty sure they're already gone by now, which is a huge issue. Oh no, the person I want for kicker has not been taken yet, so I need to take him now. I totally forgot about this because obviously we don't really have a kicker. So I want Ty Simbraglio. Yep, this man. And then my backup quarterback. I don't know if he's still there. Right tackle. Okay, I think he might still be there. He's not. I wanted Titus Howard as my other
The Cardinals are now on the clock.
All right, well, hopefully we can still get our punter. I think so. Chuma Edoga, right tackle. I think he was still there. Yep. All right, so we missed out on that backup quarterback. Like, I just completely forgot about taking. However, did still get a decent amount of players. Still got our starting kicker, starting punter, starting QB. So now we should go for awareness, actually. Like, I think that's actually a smart football decision. We'll just go through, we'll get two players with the highest awareness from each position right now. Because I actually feel like that will really help us on the defensive side of the ball.
The Cardinals are now,
you know, obviously it's not play rec, but I think there should be a little bit of a correlation between awareness and play rec. At least I hope so. And if not, this should just help in overall and in general. I hope. And our nice thing is offensive lineman group is so diverse in age as well. Like, we don't have to take, and we're not taking multiple 70-some overalls. You know, there's been a couple of times we've taken, one round we've taken a 32-year-old, next round we've taken a 25-year-old, and then a 23-year-old, and then back up to 31. It's just been kind of nice to see all of that play out.
The Cardinals are now on the clock.
So now obviously this is going to be, it's going to be tough from my perspective in having to figuring out who's going to play what position. Because obviously it doesn't really matter. It doesn't matter that much, but I mean, there could be a couple. Like, if a player is really good at outside linebacker, but he's also an amazing tight end, what do I do then? The other thing is, tight end and fullback are obviously going to be amazing because of their ability to block, but that doesn't correlate to their ability to catch the ball, or their ability to run the ball, or their ability to run routes. So it's going to be a process. I'm not going to show that process because it takes me like literally an hour to go through and change all the positions, players into the right position, change their numbers, and it legitimately takes me around an hour. And I don't want to bore you guys. I think now we should just go for the largest men.
The Cardinals are now on the
clock. Just find the largest players that we can take. Nice, 6'6", we'll take Tom Compton.
The Cardinals,
I mean, the thing we'll always have an advantage on every single other team is size. And I don't think anybody's going to be questioning that. And really, if we can just take full advantage of our strength and size, that can really help us. Six-foot-eight. Brandon Parker.
The Cardinals are now on the clock.
That Parker dude we just took, that 6'8", he could end up being our slot corner. Like, that's how crazy this experiment is actually going to end up being.
The Cardinals are now on the clock.
So I think, yep, Kasenberry's still there. I'm pretty sure he's one of the faster offensive linemen, if I'm not mistaken. Alright, now we'll just take three right tackles to kind of balance out the team. And then we're going to And then we're going to start figuring out this team.
The Cardinals are now on the clock.
Boy, is it going to be interesting.
The Cardinals are now on the clock.
I am thoroughly excited to see how this ends up turning out. Zach Banner. Aw. He's a pretty good player. And with the 54th pick, because I understand why they have the 54th pick. I mean, it's really a waste of a player. Because I usually end up taking Colby Wadman. It approved. I'm not lying to you guys. And oh, he's going to use the punter, and he'll somehow make him into an amazing
start
player.
By installing your game plan.
No. I will go in here myself. Go to the punter. I'm going to show you all. I am
this
releasing
is the
him.
Player card. Here you can see your player strengths and...
There. See? There's proof. Alright, so looking at the team now, I'm pretty sure we were 51 overall. Yeah, 51 overall with a 95 overall in offense. But if we go into our lineup, obviously you'll see there's a significant lack of... Well, non-offensive linemen. So, I'm going to go offline, go through and edit all these players, and I'll let you guys, and I will essentially show you guys the final team in just a second. Alright guys, so after I went through and edited everything, the team has actually ended up being a 38 overall, with a 58 overall offense and a 15 overall defense. And we'll go through the depth chart now, just kind of see how the entire team looks. As I said, Lynn Johnson in at QB. Brandon Scherff will be our starting running back. We also got Cameron Tom, Justin Murray, and James Hurst. Starting fullback will be Brandon Brooks. Wide receiver, we've got Nate Solder, David Kessenberry, Laurent Duvernay-Tardif, Ali Marpet, and Cameron Irving. At tight end, we have Donald Penn, Jason Peters, and Ike Bodiger. Left tackle, I've moved Richie Incognito from left guard to left tackle. Left guard, we have Quinton Nelson. At center, Jason Kelsey. Right guard, Zach Martin. Right tackle, Brian Beluga. At left end, we got Justin School. We have Ryan Jensen at right end, Rodney Hudson, Matt Paradis, and Andres Pete at defensive tackles. Shantley at left outside linebacker. Middle linebacker, we got Wyatt Teller, David DeCastro, and Connor McGovern. At right outside linebacker, we have Tom Compton and David DeCastro. At corner, we have Donovan Smith, Andrew Norwell, Sua Opeta, Patrick Morris. Our free safety is Ben Garland. Strong safety is Nick Easton. Kicker is Ty Sam Braglio. Punter is Chuma Edoga. So that's just essentially what the team has ended up looking like. Look, give you a little bit better view of everything in the lineup section. Obviously, the team is very well rounded on the offensive line. Tight ends are actually pretty decent. QB, running back, wide receiver is definitely lacking. And on the defensive side, it's pretty consistently bad all around. And obviously, special teamers are not the greatest. So if you have enjoyed, if you're still here, you have enjoyed, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Leave like the video, I guess. And just let me know you're somehow watching, whether that be a comment or just like. And it is Jay Beebs signing off. What's up, guys? It is Jay Beebs here, and here at the final episode of this series. We're 1-6. We're not going anywhere this series. We're not going anywhere this season. We're not making it to the playoffs. It's just not going to happen. So I talked about last season, or last episode. I'm just going to end it here. It was quite the ride. It was quite the run. We did pretty well. Had our moments. Didn't have our moments. Played well. Played pretty terrible. But in the end, there was a lot more downs than there were ups. We were just kind of heading for disappointment in every game, so that is why I've evidently decided to end the series. There's a lot of promise, there's a lot of hope at the beginning. I thought after the first couple of games we still hadn't gotten a win. It was just, you know, it's a learning curve. Then we got our first win, and I was like, let's go, we're back on track. But after two terrible losses in a row, I decided that last episode was it. We're done. We're just going to send him to the end of the season. But yeah, pretty disappointing. I really thought the series would work. I thought it'd be pretty fun. I thought it'd be a blast to do. But evidently, it was not good enough. I assume we're gonna finish 1-15. Maybe like 1-14-1. But I mean, it's disappointing because I don't like to end. I don't want to end a series like this, you know. Yeah, we've ended up going 1-15. Yeah, that's tough. But yeah, that's gonna end it. Not at all a fun journey. And not at all did not deserve to end this way. But I mean, I guess the CPU. These are practice squad players that got promoted. But yeah, that's it. I hope you guys all enjoyed this. Check out other series on my channel. They're a lot more enjoyable than this. But unfortunately, I'm all done. I hope to see you guys all in the future. And it is JBeebs signing off.